Howdy, folks. Live from Big Top Chautauqua, welcome to another episode of Kent Show Radio.
I can't believe another year's going around. Is that a big top I see there lying on the ground? Ballyhoo. Ah, ballyhoo.
Support for Kent Show Radio is provided by Travel Wisconsin. Fun ideas for your Wisconsin getaway, from dining and destinations to attractions and accommodations, are available at TravelWisconsin.com or on our app for iPhone and Android. And by Northwoods Brewing of Eau Claire, Wisconsin, dedicated to craft brewing specialty beers including Flop and Crappie, Lil Bandit Brown Ale, and Poplar Porter. NorthwoodsBrewPub.com. And now here's your host of Kent Show Radio, best-selling author, humorist, singer-songwriter, and part-time pig farmer, Michael Perry.
Thank you, Phil, and howdy, Kent Show folks. It's great to be way up north here under the beautiful blue and pearl gray canvas, this fine stout tent at the foot of Mount Ashwa Bay, overlooking the ancient waters surrounding the Apostle Islands and just one sail full of breeze away from Shawamigan Bay. The performance you're about to hear is one in a long, long tradition of singing, dancing, and storytelling performed live and in person beneath this beautiful tent. We keep our pitch from June until the autumn moons, and we'd be most grateful if you choose to join us. You'll find a complete schedule at bigtop.org. We hope you join us, and if you do, when the first note rises from the stage, we think you'll understand why patrons and performers alike love to say, "Big Top Chautauqua." It's the Carnegie Hall of Tent Shows. Tonight on Tent Show Radio, a special concert featuring the musicians and singers of the Blue Canvas Orchestra. Other acts come and go, but you can always rely on the BCO. And later on, during intermission, I'll discuss my losing battle with entropy. Ladies and gentlemen, I love to share the story of this tent. How it perches high on a hill overlooking the Apostle Islands. How its position between the stars overhead and their reflection in Lake Superior below create a feeling of magic wrapped in canvas. And how this tent is able to make even the largest crowds feel like a cozy gathering of friends. I loved to come hear music in this tent long before I ever stood on the stage, and still do. But for all the big names and big acts to come and go, and this tent hosts a wide variety of the very best, no group has been a more constant source of joy and song than our very own Blue Canvas Orchestra. The BCO is in the tent tonight, ready to share a selection of songs from the various house shows they perform throughout the season, and I'm as happy as anyone in the place, because nothing says tent show like the Blue Canvas Orchestra. Joined tonight right out of the gate by special guest vocalist Danielle Diamond and later Corey Carlson. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go with the BCO.
Was in the lost and found. You're no good.
grateful Tent Show radio host at sneezingcow.com. Yep, just the way it sounds. I'm going to head on back home now, reliving memories of what it was like when we used to own a car. Drive careful. If you can't drive careful, watch out for the other guy. We'll see you next time. And remember, where I come from and here at Tent Show Radio, nobody ever says goodbye. They just say, well, I suppose.
Next song comes from a festival that took place 45 years ago this summer.
What?
Yeah. Do the math. And of course it happened in White Lake, New York.
I was told there'd be no math.
But everybody knows it as Woodstock. And there were, before the festival was over, there were over 500,000 people there. 500,000 people came to that concert. And if you watch the movie, it takes about as long as the concert took. And but about 500,000 people came, but at last count, about 2,750,000 people claimed to have been there. And about 10% of them weren't even born in 1969. Well, I came upon a child of God. He was walking along the road. I asked him, well, where are you going? And this he told. We are stars, we are ghosts, we are billion-year-old carbon, and we've got to get ourselves back to the garden. Well, can I walk beside? Time of man, but I don't know who I am, but life is for learning. We are stars, we are golden, we are billion-year-old carbon, and we've got to get ourselves back to the garden. Stardust, we are ghosts, we are billion-year-old carbon, and we've got to get out. to the garden. By the time we got to Woodstock, we were half a million strong. And everywhere there was song and a celebration. And I think I saw the bomber there playing riding shotgun in the sky. We are stardust, we are goldust, we are caught in the devil's bargain, and we've got to get ourselves back to the
love the one you're with.
Well, don't be angry
ask you, and she's just waiting for something to do. And there's a road in the distant valley where the eagle flies with the dove. And if you can't be with the one you love, honey, love the one you're with.
I will lay me down.
sail on by. Your time has come to shine. All your dreams are on.
Listening to Tent Show Radio.
Welcome back to Tent Show Radio, folks, from the backstage dressing room with the one lonely little light bulb burning. Lately, I've been considering life's imperfections. These ruminations generally commence in the morning, which is to say, the moment I face a mirror. Things are falling apart apace. The old jawline isn't what it once was. The lines bracketing my chin look ever more like those of a human nutcracker or a ventriloquist mannequin. And you could plant pine seedlings in the twin furrows cleaving what should be my two eyebrows. Only once have I had two eyebrows, and that was after a woman in a French hair salon in New York City's Upper East Side attacked me with a tweezers in a manner possibly violating the Geneva Convention. I was conducting what some in the trade call participatory journalism at the time, although when I tried to explain that down to the fire hall, no one would listen. There are upshots to my physical decline. Chief among them my retirement plan, which is based on investing the money I'm saving on hair care products, as my annual needs are easily satisfied and even exceeded by harvesting motel mini shampoos during book tour. I generate additional dividends by serving as my own barber. At this point, it is less like giving myself a haircut and more like mowing the weeds on a vacant lot. Occasionally, this plan leads to my emerging in public with an accidental strip of occipital fuzz. But I can't see it, so it doesn't really bother me, and besides, most people are so distracted by my single eyebrow they never really notice the back of my head. Sadly, whatever time I have saved by the recession of the hair adorning my dome is being more than consumed by all the trimming and pruning required to keep at bay hair which is paradoxically thriving, specifically that sprouting from my nose, ears, and eyebrows. There's some sort of inversely proportional thing happening here, and I could do three paragraphs on the phenomenon, but some of you may be trying to digest supper. Finally, it takes longer to shave these days. Oh, I still lather up and scrape my face in the same amount of time as ever, but that's just the first shave. Because at my age, after the first shave, you have to put on your reading glasses and quickly, before they fog up, check out all the spots you missed because you can no longer actually see individual whiskers. It's that second shave that fools the world into thinking you're doing fine with activities of daily living and keeps your family from sitting you down for the talk. You know, even in the dim light of the one lonely little light bulb burning back here, I can see in the dressing room mirror that it's time for a haircut. My scalp has taken on the appearance of a late-stage anemic dandelion. When my hair gets to this point, neither long nor short, it results in a look floating somewhere between uncommitted nutty professor and dissolute drill sergeant. I'll lose a little time with the clippers, as well as the requisite ear, nose, and eyebrow hedge trimming, but maybe I'll make it up with a swift mini-shampoo and by skipping the two-stage shave completely. I can grow a decent, if not voluminous, beard, and whatever it may or may not do for my looks, it does guard the cheeks and chin against the cutting winds of Wisconsin winters. Also, with each passing year, it resembles more and more the snow, a useful form of camouflage should it come to that. And while we're on the topic of camouflage, the beard eases those morning mirror sessions by obscuring any unhappy jawline developments or exacerbated nutcracker face. Of course, this leaves the twin furrows. Perhaps if they become overly worrisome, I can let the eyebrows go and perform some sort of unibrow comb-over. And now, with that image stuck in your head, good luck enjoying the rest of the show. Once again, the BCO.
He said I'd be better dead than alive. I didn't listen to his jive. I knew all along that he was all wrong, and I knew that he thought I was crazy, but I'm not. My analyst told me that I was right out of my head. He said you need treatment, but I'm not that easily led. He said I was a type that was most inclined, went out of his sight, to be out of my mind. And he thought I was nuts, no more lips or ends or buts. They say as a child I appeared a little bit wild with all my crazy ideas, but I knew what was happening, I knew I was a genius. What's so strange when you know that you're a wizard at three? To be. Now I heard little children were supposed to sleep tight, and that's why I got into the vodka one night. My parents got frantic, didn't know what to do, but I saw some crazy things before I came through. Now do you think I was crazy?
No.
I may have been only three, but
if they just couldn't understand the idiomatic logic that went on in my head. I had a brain that was suicidal. They used to laugh at me when I refused to ride on those double-decker buses, all because there was no driver on the top.
No driver on the top?
Not a
no double blick.
I'm
what?
Telling you.
They must be crazy. I don't know.
My analyst told me that I was right out of my head, but I said, dear doctor, I think that it's you instead, 'cause I've got a thing that's unique and new. To prove it, I'll have the last laugh on you, but 'cause of one head, I got two. And you know two heads are better than one.
There's Jane Alexson over there on the bass and singing at the same time. How do you like that?
How does she do it? All right. This next tune, do we got everybody on stage? Everybody ready to go? It's another one from Ladies of the Laurel Canyon, a Carole King tune called Chains.
Before we do this, let me just say this is going out to Jerry Goffin, who wrote this song. We wrote a couple of these tunes tonight. Him and Carole King were married. And great songwriter, died yesterday at 75, so he wrote this song. So let's do this for him.
Chains, my baby's got me locked up in chains, and they ain't the kind that you can see. Whoa, these chains of love got a hold on me, yeah.
It's hard to get by just upon a smile. It's a wild world, and I always remember you like a child girl. Edward.
Lying on her own, she was a broken heart. She's not the kind to take you down for long. She knows and plays it smart. And if she's leaving, she showed no mark. She's heard no whistle blowing from the dark. She feels like leaving and she don't know why. Without no bridges, she trapped, so I'm sighed. Don't cross the river if you can't swim the tide. Don't try denying living on the other side. On your mind, you're on your own. And if you want, you can ride my train. Soon forget the reason that you're leaving. Lose yourself and then sometime, maybe even save yourself some grieving. Don't cross the river if you can't swim the tide. Don't try denying living on the other side. Don't cross the river if you can't swim the tide. Don't try denying living on the other side all your life. The reason that you're leaving, you lose yourself and then sometime, maybe even save yourself some grieving. Ooh. Don't cross the river if you can't swim the tide. Don't try denying living on the other side. Don't cross the river if you can't swim the tide. Don't try denying living on the other side. Don't cross the river if you can't swim the tide.
Of the lonesome time. live my life in dreams of yesterday.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our very own Blue Canvas Orchestra. Thank you, friends. Thank you to special guest Danielle Diamond and Corey Carlson. The Top of Wisconsin Tent Show Radio is a production of the nonprofit Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua, the summer home of Tent Show Radio. Support for Tent Show Radio is provided by Travel Wisconsin. Fun ideas for your Wisconsin getaway, from dining and destinations to attractions and accommodations, are available at travelwisconsin.com or on our app for iPhone and Android. And brought to you by Bayfield.org. Presenting this February 7th and 8th, the 20th annual Apostle Island Sled Dog Race across the pristine snow-covered Bayfield Peninsula. Bonfires will roar as the mushers and teams are cheered on in this dramatic annual adventure. Listen more online at bayfield.org. And we're brought to you by the Bayfield Inn, located on the shoreline of Lake Superior, proudly hosting Bayfield's visitors for nearly 100 years. Rooftop deck bar and events for all occasions. Online at thebayfieldinn.com. Tune in next time on your radio or online. Station locations, Big Top summer show schedule, online ticketing, and touring schedule of the Blue Canvas Orchestra at bigtop.org or by calling 1-888-BIG-10. Or stay in touch with us on Facebook at facebook.com/bigbluetent. Tent Show Radio is produced by Tom Fabjans, Michael Perry, Jamie Hansen, and yours truly, Philip Anich. Well, folks, that's our show for tonight. Whether you join us in the tent or join us in the air, whether you beam us or stream us, we're as grateful as a guy with two natural-born eyebrows. Remember, the Big Top is open all summer long and into autumn and has been for going on 3 decades now. We'd love it if you came up and or over for a show. And if you're traveling by World Wide Web, I'd be grateful if you dropped by to visit me, your grateful Tent Show radio host, at sneezingcow.com. Yep, just the way it sounds. I'm going to head on back home now, reliving memories of what it was like when I used to own a comb. Drive careful. If you can't drive careful, watch out for the other guy. We'll see you next time, and remember, where I come from and here at Tent Show Radio, nobody ever says goodbye. They just say, well, I suppose.